everybody, welcome back to the Doghood. I'm here today and I've got my very best friend on the planet of best friends, Miley. We call her Measles. She is a 15-year-old Chihuahua, which is one of the hardest dog breeds to train to do anything, by the way. Chihuahuas are mind developers. They decide what they're going to do and they do what they're going to do. So in this particular episode, we're going to talk about dog psychology. So how does a dog's brain work? So little Miss Miley, she kind of runs things around here because, you know, well, Chihuahuas run everything. In fact, let's just be thankful that Chihuahuas are not the size of pit bulls or we'd all be dead and they'd be running the universe. Am I wrong? No. Alrighty, Miss Miley, go find yourself something to do. So let's talk about the dog brain. The dog brain loops three times and you go, looping? What's looping, Danielle? Well, this is what looping is. So there are two conscious or ways that the dog's brain reacts to the environment around it. So they can actually do two things at one time consciously, but then they have a subconscious level of their brain. That is not something that is reactive to the environment around them, okay? So let's talk about this. There is a video actually on YouTube, I think it's called Gorilla Looping, where there are basketball players, some in white shirts, some in black shirts, and they're passing a basketball back and forth. And when somebody is asked to watch the video, they are asked to count how many times the white players pass the basketball back and forth. And when you get done watching the video, you can tell the person who showed you the video, they passed it 16 times. And the person's going to say, wow, you are super, super observant. But let me ask you something. Did you see the guy in the gorilla costume that walked in between the players while they were passing the basketball? And the person watching the video goes, no, I didn't see that. What? Well, your brain can actually loop 3 to 4 times consciously and 2 to 3 times subconsciously. And I'll give you a good example of this. You ever driven your car to work and you get to work and you think, holy cow, I don't even remember the drive. Like the drive here made no sense to me because I was doing other things like trying to figure out what we were going to make for dinner that night or trying to figure out how we were going to get kids to do their homework tonight or what we were going to do on our job or all the different things in our life or even what was playing on the radio. So our conscious loops were being taken up, so our subconscious was actually driving the car. Now, our conscious and subconscious are so closely linked that if a car had pulled out in front of us, our conscious would have taken over and put our foot on the brake. But as long as no other environmental changes happen, our subconscious will continue to drive the car. Dogs are very much the same way, except they loop a lot less than people do. So, for instance, if you are walking your dog and your dog has a bone in its mouth and you've got the leash on the dog and you're walking it down the sidewalk and all of a sudden a squirrel comes out of nowhere, your dog has to do one of two things before it can engage that squirrel. What it needs to do is either drop the bone or needs to stop walking. Even if it's instantaneous, he's got to pick up that second or that third loop, which is the squirrel running out in front of him. So how does this information help us with training our dogs? So if we have behavior that is unwanted, that we can redirect, and people call it redirection, but in actuality, it's interruption is what it is. So we're adding another loop to the dog, and taking away a loop. For instance, if you're walking down the road and your dog becomes very focused on a dog across the street that's doing something else, you can actually do something, and they call it redirecting, but we are actually interrupting the loop of that particular dog. So we can either touch the dog or we can turn and walk another way, and that brings the dog into another loop, so they have to stop focusing on the dog across the street. So let's talk about this particular psychology trick or technique, so to speak, that we use on our dogs and how it basically works. So there is a subconscious marker or imprintation that you can put into your dog's psyche when you're handing out discipline to the dog. For instance, a sound. So when I make a correction on a dog, I make a sound. Now my sound is a Richard Dawson button from Family Feud. My sound is ah. When I say ah to my dogs, they stop what they're doing. They go ahead and try to decide what the next course of action is because I have imprinted on my dogs that when that sound happens, usually discipline follows very shortly thereafter, almost instantaneously after the sound. So what we are doing is we are imprinting on your dog's subconscious mind that when they hear that sound, and your sound can be anything, that after that sound, then discipline happens. So the dog knows the dog is not in the correct situation. So for instance, when you're disciplining your dog, you're playing with your dog happens to latch onto you, and you flick or you push the dog back. The minute you do that, it has to be instantaneously to the discipline itself. You make your sound. So as you are pushing the dog back, you'll say, eh, or you'll correct the dog by maybe flicking the dog's nose if they're trying to bite you, and eh, at the same time. Now the dog didn't actually hear the sound. The reason he didn't hear the sound is because you were doing a disciplinary action at the very exact same moment, but his subconscious mind did pick up the sound. So if you continue this discipline mechanism with your dog, what ends up happening is the subconscious imprints that after that sound, basic correction happens. So for instance, if you have your dog and it's off a leash and it's doing dog stuff, for instance, it sees a sock on the floor and you make your sound, even though there isn't a discipline followed it, after you've done this for several times and the dog has the understanding and it's imprinted, you can make the sound, ah, and the dog for some reason will pull his head up and look around and say, oh, no, 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 I don't want the sock. He doesn't understand why, but his subconscious absolutely does. As he's going towards that and he's in a single loop and you make that sound automatically tells that dog, we need to stop this loop at the moment. So it'll give you one of two things. It'll either give you a separation from the behavior the dog is doing, or number two, it will also give you a moment to basically get down and get a hold of that dog rather than letting the dog continue on its behavior. So I cannot stress this enough. Try this with your dog. Figure out what your sound is. And when you make that correction, do the discipline and the correction at the same exact time, so that the brain is imprinting that with a sound, correction happens as well. And what you'll find is after about a week of handling discipline out this way to your dog, you can make that sound and that dog is going to react to the sound rather than even having to handle a discipline back to the dog or a redirection back to the dog. So I hope this helps. It's called brain looping. So look it up. It's a fascinating rabbit hole to get down into if you want to get down into it for humans and dogs. But this is absolutely a given. This is some way that you can control your dog without having a leash on your dog or without having to manually grab the dog sometimes, is simply interrupt the behavior by making the sound. So please go over to our YouTube channel where all our videos are going to be hosted on, and you can watch videos one right after the other. This is strictly about dog behavior, and that is what we're trying to do here at the Doghood, is we're trying to teach our dogs to be better parts of society. We want to give them better lives. We want to teach owners how to be better owners of their dogs, to make them be more productive members of society and make it to where everybody wants to be around your dog, because your dog is the best behaved dog in the neighborhood. So by all means, go to our webpage, go to our YouTube channel, go to our Instagram, but especially come on Thursday to our lives. Every Thursday we do a live free of charge. Just come in, watch the live, and we're going to be answering questions. So if you have a question about dog discipline or behavior or feeding or nutrition, put it into that live and we'll come back on another live and answer all your questions. That's what the Doghood is all about. We are about educating the people around us. I'm the dog guru, Danielle Scruggs. I am here for you. We're going to walk this journey together. I can't wait to see where we go with this. So let's make our dogs the most productive animals in this amazing world called the Doghood. Thank you so much for visiting me.